Welcome to you all to our third recital this term. I can't believe how quickly it's gone, actually, and I know that this is a little premature, but it's so lovely to have some Christmas decorations. And so today we have two performers, Harvey and Seffi. Harvey's going to be playing the flute and Seffi playing the violin. Harvey is in upper sixth and Seffi in upper five, so a slight difference in age, but no difference in quality whatsoever. So, Harvey, come and join us.
Good afternoon. I'm going to be playing six movements today by three different composers, and beginning with Handel. And Handel was a German composer who we believe wrote it around 1725, just after he had moved to England, in fact. And Handel wrote this sonata with the typical five movements, and I'm going to start with just number one and number two. And hopefully you will pick up a little bit of the hint towards slight feeling and dance throughout throughout the sonata, especially in the second movement, which is titled the Allegro, so instantly that speed picks it up. And throughout both of them, there's a lot of dotted rhythms to help push along the piece.
Thank you.
So the next two movements are by Lennox Berkeley, who was an English composer who sadly died on Boxing Day in 1989, aged 86. And Berkeley, he had lots of local connections. He was a pupil at Gresham's, and he lived for a year with Benjamin Britten at Snape Mill in Suffolk. And he was heavily influenced by several key composers like Poulenc and Ravel, hence quite a French quality to his music. So today I will be playing the second and third movements of his Sonatina. And the second movement is a beautiful adagio, which is contrasted and followed by the third movement, which is a lot more lively.
Thank you.
So my final two movements are by John Rutter, the most modern of my pieces that I will be playing today. And the six movements in total combined together to make Suite Antique. And it's based off a Baroque style, as Rutter was asked to write it for a festival at which Bach's fifth Brandenburg Concerto was on the programme. So it consisted of the same sort of instruments and same sort of musical homage to form this style of Bach's era. So today I'm going to be playing two of the movements, the third movement followed by the second from Suite Antique. And so the third is this beautiful, very free melodic aria opening on a lovely minor key, which is followed by this incredibly lively ostinato, where you hear this constant repeated bass line and an upbeat, very syncopated, very similar to that of America and West Side Story.
Thank you.
Seffi and Brenda to have a quick glug of water. Seffi and Brenda, thank you.
We will start by playing Sonata in C minor by Geminiani. Geminiani was an Italian Baroque composer who was around the same time as Handel and Vivaldi.
Thank you.
Mozart's Concerto in G major. Mozart wrote 5 violin concertos in total, and this is his third.
Thank you.
We're going to play a movement from the F-A-E Sonata, which was written by Schumann, one of Schumann's students, and Brahms, and we'll be playing the Brahms Scherzo movement.
Thank you.
cues, firstly to the instrumentalist's two teachers, Emily Sheldrake and Anna Hopkins. An enormous amount of work goes into preparing these students. And thirdly, to Brenda, accompanying them. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing to see how the whole caboodle gets put together. And thank you so much to Brenda for making such a huge difference to their performances. We are back on January the 19th. Ashley Thorpe is playing the piano and Charlotte Pollard, soprano. So that would be wonderful. Thank you very much.